someone being called a Hoosier when they're not from Indiana? What's with St. Louis? Well, the answers are in this book by Valerie Battle Kensel, and she's joining me right now. And this book is getting a lot of attention because somebody has finally written it, and it was you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what is it with the rolling stop in St. Louis? I've noticed that for years. I even did stories on it. Can't figure it out.
Well, there are 1,000 miles of streets in St. Louis, and there are 22,000 stop signs.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, there's actually a regulation in St. Louis that you do need to come to a complete stop where your car does that little jerk.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, a lot of people do roll through stop signs and look and then go. But really, stop signs are there for safety.
I remember the first time somebody said, hey, your neighbors are Hoosiers. And I went, oh, great. They're from Indiana. And they said, what? Yeah, where did that all start?
Don't really know how it started, but other parts of the country, people are called rednecks or
yahoos,
hicks.
Yeah.
Yes.
And that's what it means.
Yes.
Yeah.
Somebody who puts plastic flowers in their pots year round and it snows on them.
And then we have the name Mound City.
Yes.
Mound City. And it must come from the Indian mounds, the burial mounds, or at least the effigies.
Yes. At one point, St. Louis had over 24 of those, and the riverboat captains would come up the Mississippi and they would see the mounds and they knew they were approaching St. Louis. Sadly, they're all gone except one. There is Sugarloaf Mound, and that overlooks 55 and the Mississippi, and it does have a house on it.
Yeah, and up by the Stan Musial Veterans Memorial Bridge, there was one. There's just a plaque there now. Mm-hmm. At least there was until recently.
Yeah.
And then the ghost signs in St. Louis, we see these on the sides of buildings.
Yes, yes. Most of them are 100 plus years old. Before there were billboards, before there was television, radio, they tried to have advertising that's reach the most number of people, trains, buggies, whatever. The paint had lead in it, so that's why you still see it around a lot.
Oh, I see.
And the people who painted these were called wall dogs. They traveled around the country. This was before OSHA standards, so they had their ladders and their buckets, and they painted like sometimes 12, 15 hours a day.
And if they got any of that paint on them and they didn't have indoor plumbing, they'd head to the bathhouse.
Yes.
And we still have one. I know it's up by Crown Candy Kitchen near St. Louis Avenue.
Yes. At one point, St. Louis was a very stinky, smelly place. We had lots of immigrants that had moved to St. Louis who didn't always have the same hygiene standards that we have today. And so officials, the powers that be, decided in the early 1900s that it was a good idea to have public bathhouses built. So a series of 6 different bathhouses. They had separate doors for men and women. You could bring your own towel or your own soap, or you could rent for 5 cents. And from what I've understood, they became quite the social gathering place, especially on
right?
Saturday nights. Yes.
How about that?
Yes.
All right, we've got one still standing, I think, or there are more.
That's yes, just, that's yes, up near Crown Candy.
And finally, the brain sandwich.
Yum, yum.
We both agree, we've tried them and it's not for us.
No.
Yeah, but it's a big thing in St.
Definitely
Louis.
Not.
And you can still get them where? At Shotzi's?
Shotzi's. But it used to be they were cow brains. And since the mad cow disease, they are now pork brains.
All right. Well, you've got a book signing coming up if you want to learn more about this book. And it's What's with St. Louis. This is coming up from 7 to 8:30, Tuesday, December 6th at the Missouri History Museum in Forest Park. And we'll have more information on our Fox 2 app. Thank you so much for coming in and sharing your book. It looks like a good one. A lot of people are talking about it.
Thank you.
All right. Continued success. All right, let's go back to Lisa.